It has been nearly 2 years, but after millions of dollars were set aside, renovated homes stand empty at a state public housing project. In November of 2012, the state held a groundbreaking ceremony at Palolo Valley Homes. The promise of a vibrant and modern housing project was backed by more than $11 million in construction funds. Today, the renovated buildings are fenced off, even after residents were told they could move in last March. Nestor Garcia dug deeper and found out why the renovations have taken so long. Ness?
Joe, I was first alerted to a locked parking lot that forced many of the residents to struggle with parking out on the street. But then I came across three of the newly renovated buildings at Palolo Homes, and I wondered why they were surrounded by a fence. The residents also asked me to find out what was going on.
For more than a year, red cones have marked the spots for cars on the street at Palolo Homes for dozens of residents who have had to make do because they have been locked out of their reserved stalls in this newly paved parking lot.
Using our reported feature, a resident who wishes to remain anonymous asked KHON 2 News why this parking lot has been closed since at least January of 2013. But as we dug deeper, we found out that there's more than just a closed parking lot here.
As I walked the neighborhood, I also came across what appeared to be three newly renovated buildings at Palolo Homes. The residents were told they were supposed to move in back in March. But residents I spoke with did not know why the apartments continue to stand empty. I spoke to the executive director of the State Public Housing Authority, and he explained that the problem centered on how to alert the residents to an emergency. The problem centered on who would monitor the project's new fire sprinkler system should there be an emergency and the alarm is sounded. Normally, you would hire a private agency to do that job, but there was a question of who would assume the liability. According to the state, the problem was solved by agreeing to two conditions with the city. The state agreed to install an alarm not just inside, but outside each of the buildings as well. The state will also inform residents of an additional emergency number to call in addition to 911.
Last month in August, the third week of August, we got approval from the city and county to go ahead and get the seal to be able to move the people. We agreed on some monitoring system. Some buildings are ready, others are in the process of getting ready. So within the next 30 days, everybody else will be moved there.
As for that parking lot, the executive director had to ask the private company that manages the housing project for an update.
We inquired. The reason was the lighting that was there was not sufficient to be safe, and they had to procure it to get it done.
Now that parking lot will be open in a couple of weeks. I will continue to monitor the renovation work and will report on whether the delays will add to that $11 million initial price tag for the entire project. Nestor Garcia, KHON 2 News.